From the beginning, we were wrong. And only now, well into the second decade of the conflict, have we begun to understand the mistakes we have made. We lived in harmony among the Fae, in a world awakened to new magic. Perhaps we should have foreseen what might be born on this rising tide. What force might awaken? A force powerful enough to twist even the eternal and immutable faith of But Gadflo, the new king of the Winter Court, surprised us all. Singular among his people, he was all that other Fae were not. Aggressive, ambitious, visionary. He had power like none we had ever seen. Terrible and deadly. Gadflo and his followers, the Tuatha De Onn, believed that a new god was to be born in the east, beneath Gadflo's crystalline fortress of Amethan. In the name of that god, they marched to war against the young races of Amalur. Against a mortal army, no matter the power of their god, we might have been victorious. But the Fae are creatures of magic, not bound by the laws of life and death. Such Tuatha fallen on the battlefield would soon rise again, for the Fae do not know death as we do. How could we stand against such a force? For 10 years the war raged. For 10 years the armies of men and Alfar fought and died. But as our numbers dwindled, we knew that it was only a matter of time. Our fate had been written. At least, that is what we believed. Until you died.
What do you think this one is then? Alfar? Lolan? Could even be a Jotun.
Always a surprise, eh, Garan?
Eyes on the job, boy. Don't matter what it is. Dead's dead. And be thankful for that. All we've seen. Go on and pull back the sheet, though. It'll need to be in our report, one way or the other.
You
Varani. Must have been a mercenary, come to fight in the war. I could have told him how he'd end up. Not in bad shape, though, all things considered. All right, then. Make sure it goes into the report. You know he'll want all the details.
Amazing how well the body held up. Better than I've seen.
I'm just glad it's not moving. Must have been born under a lucky star, this one.
Anything else we need?
Unless you'd like to name him, I think we're done. Put him with the others.
Well, that's it for you then. Better luck next time.
They're all over. Run!
Scatter, children of dust! Scatter before the might of the Tuatha! Stay away!
Anybody!
You! Up there, please help me! Please!
Poor mortal scum! No. You'll all die.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. I, if you hadn't come along, I've seen you before. On the slab, you were dead. It worked. By the dome, it worked. You're alive. No, clearly not anymore, but you were. The Well of Souls remade your body. We thought you were another failure, but the well restored your soul to your body, and it worked. We must get you to Professor Hughes right away. He'll have questions for you. Oh, no doubt, but we must get to Hughes. He'll be in his study on the ground floor. The Tuatha are coming in through the lower levels. If we hurry, we should be able to beat them to the top. Take these. They'll help keep you safe long enough to get to Hughes. Now, let's get going! Let me get this going. Right this way. You go first. This is what they're after. Our greatest invention. The Well of Souls. Imagine an end to war. An end to death! Storerooms. See if you can find anything useful. Wait! Do you hear something? More Tuatha!
Ice time, Marty!
You're going to need more than just that sword. That one had a bow. Get it?
Best shoot them before they see us. counters are deadly if you catch an enemy unaware. Their speed more than makes up for their size. More up ahead. If you can sneak up on them with your daggers, you should be able to finish them quickly and quietly.
Look at the mortal firm scatter.
Cave blossoms only respond in the presence of magic. Perhaps there is more to you than it seems. Incredible! What are you? Thank you.
completely covered the tunnel. Maybe you can use that staff to burn a path through. Not more spiders. Burn them. Burn them.
Praetorians are temples in battle.
Get away!
The finest
steel. That's what I intend to find out. He came out of the well.
What? Then he'd better get inside to see the old man. Quick, before those Tuatha make another push.
This is where we part ways. But take whatever you want from this armory. We might have a few things that would fit you. Just make sure you get your shoes. We can hold off the Tuatha here. There's nothing more I can do except to stay here and slow down the Tuatha. But this is the armory, after all. Check the chests. We might have a few things that would fit you. With luck, I'll see you on the outside. I'll see you on the outside, if fate wills it. Protects quite like layers of impervious metal. Leather armor is thick, but will give you the speed to reach an enemy's throat. Simple cloth frees your body and mind. That's why mages prefer it.
You've made it, and look at you. Even with all you've been through. The Tuatha, your return from the dead. Please forgive me. You must be terribly confused by all of this. I am Fomorous Hughes, and this is my laboratory at Alistar. Everything you see here is dedicated to one thing. The Well of Souls. The pursuit of immortality. And you, you're my first success. If we only had the time, there's so much we might learn from one another. Too much to explain right now. The Tuatha have come to stop my work, but I don't believe they know about you. Not yet. What's important is getting you out of here safely. You're the only proof of what we've achieved here. I may not be able to save the well, but I can ensure that its only success is safe. Absolutely not. I've got my notes, but it's most important that you stay safe. It's just that you're... Wait, where are you going?
Fascinating. Simply astounding. I'm not certain what's caused it, but somehow...
Yes, as I was saying, I'm not sure what... Perhaps I should go see.
Sir, Mr. Hughes, the Tuatha have reached the lab. That inside the...
No! We've got to get you out of here now! Quickly!
Follow the path to the town of Gorhart. Find Agath. He's a friend, and he may be able to help. No matter what else, stay alive!
No!
Oh.
I saw you fighting there. We could have used more of you. Did they really have a troll? I don't know how the Tuatha found us, but if they had a troll, it couldn't have been an accident. Fate was kind to collapse that doorway behind you, or they would have chased us into the glade. Good luck out there.
Thank Matharu, another survivor. Are there any more? I suppose that's a little bit of kindness from fate. May those still trapped inside rest peacefully. Stay safe. We'll be moving soon.
remember you. You're the one? How did you come back? How did you find me here? When I saw you with Ensel in the well, I ran. But it wasn't because I was afraid. I was coming to report that Hughes's experiment had succeeded. The Well of Souls is bigger than just one gnome's pet project. My contact pays well for information about its progress. I just send reports to make some money on the side. But I don't know how the Tuatha found out. This has nothing to do with them. I never wanted anyone to get hurt. But why?
You've come from the tower, haven't you? Name's Agarth. Maybe you can help an old Fate Weaver, eh?
Did he?
Poor old Fomorous Hughes. He respected the way the world works. What a shame. He's probably dead by now. The cards told me that the Well of Souls would work, but Hughes's success would come on the day of his death. He took it pretty well, honestly. Although we did a lot of drinking after that.
You? You're the one? Then that means... it all makes sense now. The cards this morning. I drew the Gravedigger, the Running Man, and the Beast.
Prepare yourself. They're coming.
Another victory!
What are you? The threads of fate. I've seen them before, but I've never seen anyone manipulate them like that. You just changed how the world was supposed to work. How did you do that? You just... fate is the will of the gods. No mortal should be able to change it. How is that even possible? Come here. I'm going to do a reading. You might be able to change the threats, but fate will still have a plan for you. I promise not to tell you if I see your death. That would be my guess. He was an academic, but he had a proper respect for fate's plan, unlike most gnomes. That's fine, but you don't have to. But I can see that you're nervous. Relax. This is what Fate Weavers do. I'll be seeing your thread in the weave of fate. Who you are, what you've done, where your path takes you. Or at least, I should be. You're real, right? I swear I haven't had that much... I am. But still, I've never seen someone whose fate was just missing. Not even when I was drunk as the King of Ballads. This doesn't make sense. All mortal creatures have a place in the pattern. You should have one too, dead or not. If this is true, and I'm not saying I believe it, then your path is yours to determine. It could mean nothing, or it could mean everything. The world is changing. You might be a sign of that, or maybe the cause. I've never had a reason to doubt my own readings, but we should consult with Arden. He's not a friend, but he's got a good eye for the tapestry. I'll meet you at his home to the east. I'm going to see if I can be of any help to the wounded at the tower.
Yeah.
What could this all mean?
In halls of lore, there echoes none more grand than Olane's many feats of might, the pure and lady of the light. She is a knight of golden knot. She is the cure seeker, the conscience of the summer fae. She is the heart of spring, of day.
Everyone just stand back. The warden can't work when you're crowding so close. Go back to your business. Go on. Keep moving. This business doesn't concern you. Unless you're an expert scholar on the Fae, I'd suggest you move along. No reason to be out in the open with the Red Legion about. I don't know if you noticed, but St. Ordwig's mission closed its gate moments before that Fae's body turned up on the road. I don't like what that suggests. Not at all. Hi.
Hi.
I don't care what you race. It's a tragedy whenever anyone's savage like this. Just look at the poor creature. She's been beaten to the brink of death. The Fae may be strange, but they certainly don't deserve this. It appears she was attacked with some manner of short blade, likely a dagger, although there's no way I can be sure. People simply stood by as she called for help. No one lifted a finger. Can you imagine? It's shameful to treat another in such a way, even if she is a Fae. I don't know whether we possess the knowledge to treat such a wound. Frankly, I don't even know if I could save a mortal with such grievous wounds. Well, you're the only one. With all the troubles we've suffered in this village, people are weary of adversity. They'd rather just ignore it. I'm going to suggest something a bit... untraditional. There's a fae named Eri. She spends her days up on the hill overlooking the village. Seek her wisdom. I would do it, but... I am a coward. That's the truth. Perhaps a fae will know how to heal a fae. If not, then we're back where we started. She spends her days in the precipice overlooking the village. She doesn't think we're aware of her presence, but we most certainly are. Hope you stay in town.
here is the order Sotharu has given us. I see no order in accepting the truth. That is chaos. That is what the mission fears. Are we not lied to enough? We are at war. We scrabble for every supper. We live in fear of one another. Shouldn't the mission unite us?
See Nanny for alchemical goods.